That's what the last promotion brings. And right now we're going into the next bout of the evening. Let's introduce the referee for the bout, Wahab Magin. And the next bout is time, 6 rounds of boxing for the National Lightweight Challenge Contest. And it's time to bring the boxers out, make their ring wall. First fighting out of the blue corner, make welcome Abdulaziz Rewan.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is 8 rounds of National Lightweight Challenge between Abdulaziz Rewan and Sadiq Oyakhoja. Ladies and gentlemen, the judges from the bout, Tayo Olaifer, Shego Adesanya, the judge, and the referee will have matters. Also, G. Ralph Chigas, the judge, the ring announcer for this bout. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the last boxing promotion and sanctioned by the Nigerian Boxing Body Control, led by Dr. Rafael Olaifer. Now you can catch us live on Fight TV, ladies and gentlemen. My name is the Hurricane, and you can call me the Angel of Boxing, and still standing by on this arena.
And now introducing the fighters, first fighting out of the blue corner, weighing at 61.6 kilograms, with a career record of 3 fights, 3 wins. Two wins of his 3, coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Abdulaziz Rewan. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, in green and gold, weighing at 60.5 kilograms, with a striking record of 7 fights, 3 wins, 2 losses, 2 draws, all 3 wins coming by way of knockout. Former national super featherweight title challenger, and ladies and gentlemen, he is Sade Godinbo Oyakojo.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bouts are on the way. Golden Boy, Sodiko Yakojo, has been introduced to the ring, and he's a face-off between these two prolific Nigerian boxers. Golden Boy against Saromi. Ladies and gentlemen, expect the spectacle tonight on the Lads Boxing Promotion, sanctioned by the Nigerian Boxing Board of Control.
This bout is for 6 rounds. Seconds are out. Round one.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bout is underway. Sadiq Oyakojo, the Golden Boy, versus Saromi Abdulaziz Rewan. And the Golden Boy throws a jab to test this man to see how good and strong he is, as these two boxers are ready to go all the way. Upcoming there from Saromi, but the Golden Boy has all it takes to evade the punches coming from Saromi. We expect to see a powerful bout, and swings coming in from Rewan Abdulaziz, aka Saromi, as he throws a jab. He's fighting above the stables off Niger Hood Boxing Star Promotion against Golden Boy. This is a bout that you can't afford to miss. You should stay glued to your TV set as this fight goes on the way. Both boxers are taking the time to size up each other, and a good one coming there from Rewan. Another powerful punch here coming from Rewan on the hoop. Loses target, ladies and gentlemen. We have started seeing this power punches coming out from the gloves of the Golden Boy as Saromi tests his man with some good body shots and powerful combinations going to the body and to the head of the Golden Boy. Good one coming, and both of them catching themselves up on the ring. These two boxers testing themselves. I see that the jabs are coming in. Quick jabs from the Golden Boy, and also quick reflexes also from Rewan Saromi. Ladies and gentlemen, catches him on the head, but he still takes a stand. Wide shots coming in there as the Golden Boy stylishly evades those shots coming, and he catches the man with the uppercut. Both boxers are tested and trusted. A good one coming in, catches Saromi on the good vision there by the Golden Boy. And the referee momentarily stepped about as it goes to the end of the round of war, ladies and gentlemen. It's a classic show from the Lads Boxing Promotion, sanctioned by the Nigerian Boxing Board of Control. We're moving on to the round of two as we go to the replay and see how the first round went. And as you can see, the jabs coming in from the right punches are coming in, and the hooks are coming in, but all are going wide, and both of them are taking their time to size each other before they go for the kill. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, Saromi throwing his jabs, coming in with the hook and body jabs, but the golden boy evades and makes sure that his man gets the taste of his own actions. Moving on to the round of two, ladies and gentlemen. It is the six rounds of the National Lightweight Challenge bout between Abdul Aziz Ruwan and Sadiq Oyakhojo. And both fighters waste no time in engaging each other on the ring. Good one there coming from Sarim in the crowds. I liking what they're saying. The power punch is coming from Sarim's end, but the golden boy stands his ground as he takes the war to Abdulaziz Ruwan. Good one there coming from the golden boy. Good jabs coming there from both boxes. And we expect to see more combinations come from them. And the one coming in, and it catches the man on the ring. The golden boy takes a fight. Saromi returns back. And firepower coming in from both boxes. Good boxing move there from both boxes. And both of them trick punches at the edge of the ring. And the golden boy takes it straight to the side to Abdulaziz Ruwan. Saromi, as the referee breaks the bar of the fight and calls for re-engagement. Good one coming there. The golden boy catches this man and the point up and the move. The punches are flowing in, the misses are coming in, and this box is a good uppercut coming from Saromi. I guess you can hear the crowd chanting golden boy, golden boy. It seems like it's the crowd favorite, but I think Abdulaziz Ruwan is doing some beautiful boxing show here, and I think the crowd is loving this. A good jab there coming from both fighters. And the one there coming in from golden boy catches the man on the chin. And there goes the end of the round of two, ladies and gentlemen. The crowd are loving this. Stand up Nigeria. This is Nigerian boxing, ladies and gentlemen. Sadiq Oyakhojo and Abdulaziz Ruwan doing what they know how to do best on the ring. We're moving on to the round of three as we see the replay. Good one there, the catches Saromi, as you can see. And that one again. This box is threatening punches. Power punches, so to speak. As the bout is proceeding, you never can tell whose side this wager is going to, because those boxes are actually doing themselves a whole lot of favor by throwing good punches. Those of them are wide, but most of them are connecting and making the crowd love this boxing show so very much. In the round of three, Sadiko Yakoja, the Golden Boy, is on green and yellow boxing trunks. And Abdulaziz Rowan is on black and golden boxing trunks. And ladies and gentlemen, there's a wide punch in the crowd coming in from Sarumi as takes a wide punch. So the round of three is on the way and both boxers exchanging some beautiful power combinations and some body shots there. You can see Golden Boy hunting his man. Saramigi always moving back, and I think as he moves back, he moves forward too, and it's good for a boxer to fall back, prepare yourself, and go for the launch, go for the attack on the time. And that's it again, another one coming from the Golden Boy. What are you doing there coming? Here catches with Abdul Sarumi as he's about to take up his uppercut. It was caught there by right hand from the Golden Boy, which is naturally his own style. He always comes in with a checking body uppercut, but most times misses it. And I think that a Golden Boy should take opportunity of that and cross his man and stop the show. But I think the fight is going on, and both boxers actually doing justice to each other. Good job there coming from Golden Boy. Another one. Powerful right jab. Good body shot there. I'm sorry, man. Golden Boy shakes himself and says, bring it on, I'm all here waiting for you to bring in your best shot. Another one coming again and misses it, but indeed it got the crowd excited. And this time it catches the Golden Boy with a powerful uppercut, who rocks the man backwards, but his back is still standing on his feet. And it is the end of the round of three, ladies and gentlemen. It is the end of the round of three. We're moving on to our next round, ladies and gentlemen, as both fighters retire to their corners to get instructions from the seconds man and the coaches. We're in the round of four, ladies and gentlemen. Sadiq Oyakojo on green and yellow boxing trunks, while Rewan Abdulaziz on the black and golden boxing trunks. These both fighters fight in the lightweight category. This is a role play, as you can see. The quick punches and the quick jab and the uppercut and the moves that got the crowd standing
round
in that initial round. Now this is round four, ladies and gentlemen. It's on the way. Sadiq Oyakojo, Golden Boy versus Abdulaziz Rowan, aka Sarumi. Powerful shot there coming, the Golden Boy rocks his man, but his man is still standing. And the Golden Boy is on the hunting ground, hunting. And they're coming, both fighters exchanging some powerful shots there, missing each other slightly. And that is the way it is going here at the lads boxing promotion. The indoor sports of the Keslim Balogun Stadium. Good one, they're coming from the Golden Boy. who sends a right hook across to Sarami, who accepts it, and on the power move, they're coming again from the Golden Boy. Yeah, the referee, Wahab Martin, steps in to caution the fighters to avoid clash of heads. Good one coming from the Golden Boy, rocks his man. And another one coming again, misses. Crowd chanting Golden Boy. It shows he's doing some good boxing. And round four still on the way. Catches his man again on the side corner of the ring. The Golden Boy takes a powerful shot and rocks his man one more time. I think that's a low blow, and the referee really calls for caution on Enzo Weewen's arena. Those uppercuts, those flying in, most of those uppercuts have been missing, and Oyakojo returns it back, returns the favor. A good one, they're coming. Wow, the powerful shots together from the Golden Boy. This is Nigerian boxing, the crowd's excited, ladies and gentlemen. I think Sarami is always wanting to duck Golden Boy when he gets to the corner. And that means exposes himself to danger. And he allows the Golden Boy to take advantage of his open guard to take the killer shot. Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is on the way. And we are in the round of five, ladies and gentlemen. We've come to the end of the round of four. We'll move on to the round of five. So Dick Oyakojo, the Golden Boy versus Abdulaziz Rilwan, a.k.a. Sarami. Ladies and gentlemen, this battle is sanctioned by the Nigerian Boxing Board of Control, led by Dr. Rafi Oladipo. My name is the Hurricane, you can call me the Angel of Boxing, and I'm standing by with Nia Adesanya, and we're doing this commentary job together on this show. That is a great play. As you can see, both fighters trading wide punches. On both ends, and that one catches Sarami. Another one catches him again. Rocks the man head backwards, and in fact, this bout is actually heading somewhere. I mean, you really don't know who's going to take this day, but both boxers are doing their very best. And we're in the round, and the action is on the way, ladies and gentlemen. This is a round of five.
Fifth round. Fourth bout. Fifth round. Who's my what? Sadiq. Golden Boy, green and gold. Then Rilwan Abdulaziz on black and gold.
Five on the way.
Whoa, that's a slip there, and that's a bad one.
He's asleep, and the referee calls him and attention in the ring.
And that's Abdulaziz really on there. Watch it again from the playback here. And there you have it there. That's the slip.
That's the slip. No knockdown, says the referee.
And there you have it. It's a lucky one for him because he could have gotten injured there.
Yes, it is a lucky one.
Could have sprained an ankle or his knee as well. And we could see it from there again.
Wow.
Very awkward ball. Action is back now. Still the fourth bout of the night, six rounds, national lightweight challenge bout. Abdulaziz Rilwan, both of them sporting similar colors to a certain extent. Black and gold is the man they call Sarumi, and that's Abdulaziz Rilwan. Wow, that's a massive punch there from Sadiq Oyakojo. Catching his opponent just before the bell there. Up next is the sixth and final round. It's still DR's boxing promotion, Night of Champions, right here at the Maladi Okoya Thomas Hall of the Festival Balogun Stadium in Tulare, Lagos, and of course reaching out of Lagos, Nigeria. Best of Nigerian boxing. And this fight night is sanctioned by the Nigeria Boxing Board of Control as well as the West African Boxing Union. Still within the commentary area, it's none other than the one we call the Hurricane. Jeanette Imoni. Jeanette, looking forward to other bouts. We still got two title fights coming up tonight, and they promise to be very explosive.
Very, very explosive, ladies and gentlemen. The bout's underway, and this is a round of six, ladies and gentlemen.
It's the final round. Let's see what these guys have in store. Can they give the fans an explosive climax to this lightweight challenge right here? Sarumi up against the one who calls himself the Golden Boy.
I think there's an American boxer called the Golden Boy.
Yeah, that's Eddie Ann, that's right? Oscar De La Hoya.
Oh, Oscar De La Hoya, the Golden Boy. I don't think this Golden Boy fights like that Golden Boy, does he?
Let's leave it there, please. Let's just enjoy. These guys are still a long way off from being a finished product, and it's promotions like this that brings out the best in these guys. You know, they need this exposure so that they can actually expose them to international levels, and the ones who excel among themselves will definitely make it to bigger things. And we just saw one brilliant fight earlier on with that man called Abdulaziz Oshoba. He calls himself the big name, and he pulled a big punch to send out his opponent to the slumber. These two boxers really testing themselves, and I wonder why Sarumi is really trying to dance his way around, because I don't think he has really fought very well. And there you have it.
I think he's trying to avoid the punch of the Golden Boy, because so far so good, he has been punished and he has received lots of punches coming from the Golden Boy.
That wasn't a knockdown, and
it
wasn't totally a knockdown, I totally agree with him as well. But he needs to
stay put and fight. Yes.
And that was what Oyakojo did. Oyakojo literally shoved him, and I think that was what happened there. He was complaining about it, but he needed to fight as well, because Oyakojo wanted him to stay and they could have a good fight with themselves. Nice one there.
Catches this man there.
Wow,
doing the powerful shots coming
from both boxers, actually, giving themselves good body punch. Oh, Oyakojo catches it. Can he finish it up?
He's a little moment of slumber there, and Oyakojo catches his man on the way.
But Oyakojo allowed him to actually rest on him. He should have rested, kind of like shoved him away and actually go for the kill. Oyakojo let him off the hook right there. He was gone and dusted. All he needed to do was to follow up with some good combinations. He didn't do anything. Now he's allowed Sarumi to get his you know, rest again.
Yes, it's been bad.
It's not necessarily stable, but Oyakhoja is now protecting himself when he should be going for the kill.
Yes, I think he should have gone for the kill at that point in time.
See?
Always moving around, making so much mistakes, Sarumi.
He's right there to be taken out, but I don't know why Oyakhoja, he probably feels he's on the ascendancy, and there's no reason for him to take a big risk, and that's it. I think he will win the fight,
yes.
But it would have been more convincing for him to have gotten a knockout.
Oh yes, I think so too. Both boxers really did a good job. Abdulaziz Saramin from the stables of Naija, who got his permissions, and Sadiq Oyakhoja, the Golden Boy, ladies and gentlemen. It has been indeed a classical boxing show from good boxers.
And there's a payback again. You're going to see that punch catches him there.
You can see the way he moves around.
And that's where the two of them shut themselves down. And Oyakhoja trying to hunt down his opponent there. Would be nice to see that playback of that punch that rocked that man there. And that's it there.
It was in fact a powerful miss there. If he had caught his man, I don't know if I can tell what would have happened to him.
That's that punch there. And
another one caught him.
Well, he allowed the man to get a clinch, and that was the end of it. Look at it though.
Obviously, both fighters were tired. They had to go for a clinch to actually relax.
And that was the end of it. Yeah. The moment you allow, from this kind of situation, you should be looking to, you know, take your opponent out. But he rushed into that situation, and he should stand at a distance, get his points, his punches in, and he would have gotten a knockdown there. But we'll see. We'll see what the judges have to say about this at the end of it all. As we wait for our man, Ralph Chidoze George, to give us the official decision of the judges. And there's something about boxers. Whenever boxing fights are this close, you see both of them trying to... I don't know what it's all about.
The fans are not the judges.
Thank you very much. The judgment has been made.
Already.
It's just left for the ring announcer to announce it.
Well, I think it's
so
show.
No matter how much you run around the ring, it doesn't change anything.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, the two fighters have left it to the hands of the judges. And after six rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecard. And John Tayo online fast scores it 54-60. Sadiq Oyakhoja.
What?
George Chego Adesanya scores it 54-60. Sadiq Oyakhoja. And George A. George scores it 59-58. What a goal of these real ones. Your winner by split decision. Sadiq Oyakhoja.
And Sadiq Oyakhoja takes the day, ladies and gentlemen. The Golden Boy takes the day, ladies and gentlemen. He has been his man, and that's the way boxing is. You win some, you lose some.
Well, it does look like our man on the other side, talking about Abdulaziz, a real one, isn't very happy about the decision, but he put up a good spirit of sportsmanship after all. But at the end of the day, I think situations like this happen, and he didn't do enough as far as I'm concerned. He really didn't do enough to win the bout, and I'm a bit surprised that he's losing his head over the...